Hello, welcome to Grandpa's Workshop. My daughter recently bought my grandson a kitten, so I said I'd make them a scratching post. I've got this scrap piece of kitchen worktop and this reclaimed post. I'm going to use these to make my scratching post. Right, I think the quickest way to get all this paint off this wood will be to run it through the thicknesser. Now I've cut the base to size, I've centred the post by eye, and I'm just going to draw around it. And this bit's going to be removed. I'm going to be using this two-part epoxy that I got from my local pound shop. I've marked up around the base of my post. So I'm going to mix this, apply it, and put it in the base. The epoxy's dried, so this is all nice and solid. I've cut a scrap, a carpet, I've cut a square hole in the middle for it to slide over the scratching post. This edge will be covered by a piece of wooden trim, so you'll not see it. I'm going to wrap some sisal rope round for the cat to scratch. But first I've got to glue this down, and the only glue I've got is PVA glue, so I'm going to try it. Right, now I've drilled my hole. I'm going to use hot glue to secure my sisal rope in the hole. Right, now I've hot glued this first wrap round. I'm going to wrap it round now, and every so often I'll put a bit of hot glue just to secure it. I've got these bits of old draw. I'm going to reuse these, and I'm going to make some trim pieces for the scratching post. Right, now I've got all the trim pieces put on, I'm going to go around, fill any little gaps, and then it'll be time to start sanding, staining, and I'm going to call this done. Now I've finished the sanding, I'm going to stain it with Georgian Medium Oak. I'm now going to apply some clear wax. Just need to wait for the wax to dry, and then I can buff it off. And this is my completed cat scratching post, made from scrap wood and offcuts. The only thing I had to buy was a sisal rope, which which cost me around £6 for 20 metres. Thanks for watching.